Hello students, welcome to zoology class. This is Akmal Hussain, lecturer biology, Square High School and College. Now I am going to take a biology class of standard 9, chapter 1. Today's topic is classification of living world. What will we learn from this class? We will be able to know about steps of classification, system of binomial nomenclature, different steps of classification. You know, if we want to classify any organism, we have to use some steps. Among these, 7 steps are major that we must have to use to classify the classification of any organism. In classifying the organism, units or ranks are used in taxonomy, which are called taxa. The largest classification rank is kingdom and the smallest classification rank is species. At first, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and finally species. These 7 steps or taxa is mandatory to classify any organism. Different steps of classification. If we like to classify human, at first we have to write the kingdom. Kingdom, Animalia, that means they are included in animal world. Phylum, Chordata, that means possess notochord in any one phase of life. That means chorda or chordate or vertebral column is present in any stage of his life cycle or total life. Class, Mammalia. Feed their young on milk and their body is covered with hair. Order, Primate. Primate means hands with 5 fingers, suitable to grasp and vision more developed than sense of smell. Family, hominidae, that means similarity with chimpanzee, gorilla, monkey, etc. Genus, Homo, means brain is bigger compared to the body and can walk erectly on 2 feet. Species, Homo sapiens, or we may write as sapiens. Wide and high forehead, skull is thinner compared to other species, more intelligent. System of binomial nomenclature. The another name of binomial nomenclature is scientific name. For scientific name, we have to write 2-parted name. One will be genus, another will be species. This 2-parted name is called scientific name or binomial nomenclature. As per example, scientific name of potato is Solanum tuberosum. Here, the word solanum and tubersum denote the genus and species name of potato respectively. This is the picture of Carolus Linnaeus. His lifetime 1707 to 1778. He is called the father of taxonomy. That means he gave the concept or rules to classify the organism as well as the total taxonomic system. That means rules, writing steps, and also he discovered many scientific name of organism. That's why he is called the father of taxonomy. And you already well known about what is taxonomy. ICBN. ICBN is the short form of International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, and ICZN is the International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. That means botanical nomenclature, their rules and scientific name, all are controlled by ICBN, and the zoological nomenclature, that means scientific name of animal, are controlled by ICZN. Principles of binomial nomenclature. Scientist Carolus Linnaeus, in his book Species Plantarum, he wrote the rules of classify. He wrote the rules to classify the organism. Whose rules are there? On your book, there are 8 mentioned here. We will discuss the rules of binomial nomenclature. Number 1. The language of scientific naming of an organism would be Latin or Latinized. I am saying again, the language of scientific naming of an organism would be Latin or Latinized. Number 2, every scientific name should have 2 parts. Genus always comes first and then species. That means first part will be genus and second part will be species. Example, Labiorohita. Labio is here genus and Rohita is the species. And Labiorohita is the scientific name of Rui fish. Number 3, the scientific name of any organism should have to be unique. That means Labiorohita is the scientific name of Rui fish. There is no chance to be same name of another animal, another organism, Homo sapiens. Scientific name of human, only the scientific name of human. It will not be used as other scientific name, or this scientific name will not be used for other organism. Number 4, the first alphabet of the first name would be in capital letter with the remaining alphabet in small letter, and the second part of the name totally would be with small letter. Example, Apis indica. Follow here, Apis, A is here capital letter, then all will be small letter, and the species name total will be small letter. That means only one alphabet will be capital, left all will be small letter. Number five, at the time of printing of a scientific name, it would be written in italic form, as per example, Panthera Leo. Panthera Leo. It will be bent, slightly bent. That means italic form. Number six, when a scientific name is handwritten, its two parts should be separately underlined. Example, Katla Katla. When the scientific name is handwritten, its two parts should be underlined separately. Mind it, you have to write the scientific name and you have to underline these two parts separately, because you will write or you have to write it on your script. Katla Katla is the scientific name of Katla fish. Binomial names or scientific names of some organism. Rice, scientific name Oryza sativa. Oryza sativa. Number two, jute, scientific name of jute. Cocorus capsularis. Cocorus capsularis. Mango. Mangifera indica. Mangifera indica. Jackfruit. Artocarpus heterophyllus. Artocarpus heterophyllus. Water lily. Nymphe nuchali. Nymphe nuchali. Nymphe nuchali. China rose. Hibiscus rosa sinensis. Hibiscus rosa sinensis. Hibiscus is genus here and rosa sinensis combinedly species. Organism of cholera or pathogen of cholera. Vibrio cholerae. Vibrio cholerae. Organism of malaria. Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax. Cockroach, scientific name of cockroach. Periplaneta americana. Periplaneta americana. Honeybee, Apis indica. Apis indica. Ilish, Tenuolosa ilisha. Tenuolosa ilisha. Asian toad, Duttaphrynus melanosticus. Duttaphrynus melanosticus. Previous name, Bufo melanosticus. Oriental magpie robin, that means dwell, scientific name Copsychus solaris. Copsychus solaris. Tiger, Panthera tigris. Panthera tigris. Finally, human, Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens. These are some scientific name of organism, and for your kind information, you have to memorize the scientific name properly, because it will be needed for your exam as well as other, as well as higher classes. Thank you.